Whiskey Jason here, whiskey from the viewpoint of an American here in Germany today at the BCB 2019 in Berlin. Wow, that's a mouthful. Yeah, together with a
lot of bees.
Who am I talking with today?
I'm James Partridge from the Cotswold Distillery.
Very, very good. We're not in Scotland, are we?
Very far away from Scotland. Yeah, very far.
Very good. So we have this interesting area, which is very difficult for Germans to pronounce, Cotswolds. Yeah. It's a recreational area. It's a very beautiful area. It's almost like the Lake District, if you'd like. And there was a nice financial, well-situated person who got bored, right?
I don't know if it's bored. Maybe not as well financially situated as you want to be to launch a distillery, but certainly not bored, no.
That's what he found out afterwards, right?
Yeah, exactly, yeah. No, yeah, so Dan, our owner, obviously massive whiskey nut, huge fan of whiskey, worked in the city for 30-odd years, right. I believe. Whiskey was always his passion, so when he got the opportunity in the kind of the wherewithal to set up his own distillery 5 years ago, he certainly went for it, and here we are today in Berlin.
Very, very good. Jim Swan was one of your big supporters and nerds, brain power at the beginning, unfortunately passed away, but he created the STR casks as well for you, which was one of the major things that went into maybe we can show this whiskey, right?
Yeah, sure.
So what is so special about the Founders Reserve?
So the Founder's Choice, it's Founder's Choice. So it's 100% ex-Portuguese red wine barrel aging, and they're STR casks, like you say, so the Jim Swan method. And it's a cask strength whiskey. So it's at the moment it's 60.3%. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so a nice big boy. Yep. Mixes down beautifully with a little bit of water just to kind of release those oils. Lovely big red wine flavor, that beautiful malt spirit we produce coming through, and it's just been awarded Best English Whiskey at the World Whiskey Awards.
Excellent, excellent. Not everyone knows what STR stands for. Would you like to explain that, please?
So STR stands for shaved, toasted, and recharred. Mm-hmm. So essentially with a red wine barrel, you've got a huge amount of red wine flavor left in the wood once you've emptied the wine out, somewhere around 8 liters. And obviously you want to get to that. So the red wine, it acts as a bit of a barrier to entry. Mm-hmm. Yep. So what we do, well, we don't do it. Our cooperage in Portugal do it. If we did it, it'd be a horrible mess. So if I did it, it'd be horrendous. Yeah. So they shave off about 2 mil of the wood from inside the stave to kind of get rid of that red wine layer. Then you basically run it through an oven to toast it, to get those wood sugars and the wine sugars firing. And then you build the barrel back up, and you set fire to the middle of it, give it a char for 4 or 5 seconds, put it out, and that kind of allows then, it opens up fissures in the wood, which allows the spirit to get into the wood, to get that lovely wine flavor and get out nice and quickly.
Very good. So you have something new. The normal Cotswolds, I'm not even going to mention because I think this is for many, many people more important. You have a peated whiskey, yay!
We do, and it's gone down very well in Berlin. It's certainly the palate in this part of the world for a peated whiskey. I did a show in Switzerland not so long ago, and that's the right palate for that as well. So it's gone down well.
Yeah, Germans love their peated, heavily peated, if at all, single malt whiskey. If it's cask strength, they like it even more. 59.3%. Perfect.
Yeah, so it's a non-peated barley, right. So there's no peat in the Cotswolds.
Okay.
So it's the same spirit, the Odyssey barley that we produce for our other whiskies. So it's got that lovely fruity, kind of nutty feel to it. And then it's aged in ex-Isla quarter casks.
So
you get a kind of a softer smoke that comes through without that kind of that medicinal peated feel come to it, basically.
Oh, excellent, excellent. Now, that's new. What else is maybe in the pipeline? Anything you can mention for 2020, maybe?
In the future, I'm not entirely sure on release dates and which order they're going to come in. But
2021, 2022, 2023, definitely.
Yeah. Hey, it's whiskey, right? It tells you when it's ready. We don't tell it. So... you know, we have to wait for it. So we're looking probably further down the line, there'll be, you know, unsurprisingly a sherry release. And then probably because with our flagship whiskey, which I'll just stick in the camera there, that's a red wine and bourbon barrel mix. So we'll probably have a bourbon barrel release as well. And they'll likely all be at cask strength as well.
So nice. Nice.
Yeah, nice pure versions of the spirit and the whiskey that we make.
Excellent. Whiskey Jason here. Whiskey from the viewpoint of an American here. Happy at Cotswolds together with
James from Cotswolds Distillery.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.